tattooed armadillo who, when he spoke, would wheeze a raspy wheeze. She was shocked, she had been drinking. What the hell had she been thinking? Then the armadillo spoke and said, "If you please. I'm much obliged when you took that curve. You had the humanity to swerve and not run over me at the interstate. But please accept my grateful thanks for last night's lovin' for robbing banks. I've had a lot of girls, but you're really great." The armadillo lit a big cheroot, slipped out of bed into a suit made by an Italian tailor named Biatchi Klein. He said, "I have bad news, I'd love to free you from my gift of gonorrhea. A shot or two of whiskey has cleared up mine." Now about the tab that we skipped out on at the roadhouse roundabout one in Canyon with the sheriff on our tail. "I gave him your car to cover expenses. I don't see what the sense is in bringing in my name since we skipped bail. And those Chinese letters tattooed on your cheek are my name in Swahili or the days of the week. Hey, the tattoo man didn't seem to be perfectly clear. But my intentions were good, right to the last ounce. And my mama taught me it's my intention that counts. Through the hindsight, we probably shouldn't have had that last beer. Now I've been through a lot, my angel heart, and as much as it pains me to be apart, I got some business in El Paso tomorrow night. So you'll pardon me if I help myself to a handful of bills while you're in your cell. I'm good for it since you knew how to treat me right." The armadillo checked his pistol, put on his coat and started to whistle, and rummaged through her purse next to the bed. "Well, thanks for everything, my corazon. I always make love with your high heels on." And then he put his pork pie hat upon his head. "Wait just a second," she said to him. "You little roadkill, you tiny Tim. Before you go, I mean to speak my mind. If I ever see you scuttle across the road at night, you'll know who's boss, and I'll run my Chevy up your scaly behind. I might as well tell you, son of a bitch, you can go to hell or El Paso, I don't care which, but first could you just go with me for a stroll? You gave me the best night of my life, and if I weren't already married, I'd be your wife. But I'd like to share with you my first morning on parole." Well, he grinned as he took her in his arms, and he thanked God for his amazing charms. He said, "Sure, baby, there's always time for that." They were last seen walking on the side of the road. They say that she pushed him, but nobody knows. He never saw the truck that squashed him flat. Remember this tale when you're in Amarillo and you meet a slick, sexy armadillo? There's a reason that they always wind up just like that.